So next, let's see this continuation of the last topic, that is your voltage regulator. So in power supply, what was your first block? The first block was your transformer, that is your step down transformer. The output of the step down transformer was given to the next session, that is that was your rectifier. Rectifier output was given to your capacitor filter, and the output from the capacitor filter is now given to a voltage regulator. So what is meant by a voltage regulator? We can define voltage regulator as a device that regulates the output to a constant DC value. Okay, so the output will be remaining as a constant value. So what will be the input? Let me draw the diagram. So what will be the input? Input is going to be the let me tell it as unregulated DC signal, that is from the capacitor filter. So what was your capacitor filter looking like? Right, this was your capacitor filter. It had some ripples. Now we are going to eliminate this ripple by using a voltage regulator. So voltage regulator is a combination of a resistor with along the diode, that is called as your Zener diode. So this is your Zener diode, which maintains the output to a constant value. So you have a load resistor RL, wherein your V0 will be equivalent to your same voltage VZ value. Okay, so this is your simple voltage regulator circuit. So let me take the input resistor as RS. Okay, so what is going to be your output? Output will be your regulated DC signal. For example, if the input, in the input you have some ripples present, it is unregulated DC signal. In the output, you are going to maintain it in a constant value. Okay, so this is your output. So for example, if this Zener diode has a specification of 5 volt, the output will always be maintained in a 5 volt itself. Okay, so this is a concept. So what is meant by Zener diode? Zener diode was invented by an American physicist Zener, where you have the voltage to be working in a reverse bias condition, right? So in the normal, in the forward bias, it works as a normal diode. If I take this as your characteristics, right? VI characteristics. So VI characteristics. So in the reverse bias, what will happen here? This is your breakdown voltage VZ. So as the current increases, your voltage is going to be a constant. So normally the Zener diode will be working in a reverse bias condition. That is the reason why you have a negative here and a positive here. It is working in a reverse bias condition, so that whatever may be the increase in the current, the output voltage is going to be a constant value, right? So it is similar to that. You have a pipe here. Okay, let me consider this is a tap from which your water is being poured. You have a bucket here. So once the bucket is full, it gets leaked, right? So no matter what is the water you are getting from the source, the bucket water will always be remaining as a constant value. So you can take any example. So this is acting like a Zener diode. So the output will be always remaining in a constant value. Okay, now, so here there is one important, three cases are there. Okay, so this Zener diode will maintain in a constant value whenever if there is any variation, no matter if there is a variation in the input signal or in the output load resistor. So let us consider one of the case where you have the RS is a variable factor. So why you are using an RS is in order to limit the current flow. So it is also called as a current limiter. Okay. So whenever this RS is maintained between a certain limit, the output is going to be a constant value. Okay. So this is one case. Similarly, there is another case where your load resistance will get varied. So here we are going to consider the only one case, that is when RS is variable, okay, varied or when RS is varied, you have to maintain it in a certain range. So that is called as your RS maximum value and RS minimum value. Okay. So what to find, first let us consider to find RS max. So RS max is given by, so first what we are going to take is we are going to find out the voltage across this Zener diode. So I can tell it as the we are going to apply the V Thevenin's equation. So what will be your V Thevenin's voltage, which is nothing but VZ, which is equal to the resistor along this voltage divided by the total number of resistor, right? Your RS plus RL into your source voltage. If I take this as V in, okay, so V in. Okay, so this is your equation. So from this we are going to calculate our RS. So what will you get? Cross multiply VZ into RS plus RL is equal to RL into V in. So VZ into RS plus VZ into RL is equal to RL into V in. So what will be your VZ into RS is equal to RL into V in minus VZ into RL. So VZ into RS is equal to RL into V in minus VZ. So therefore RS will be equal to RL into V in minus VZ divided by VZ. Okay. Right. So RS max, I can tell that RS maximum is equal to RL into V in divided by VZ minus 1. Right. So this is going to be your RL maximum value. So what about your RL minimum value? So RS minimum value. RS minimum will be equivalent to. So what will be your RS in terms of voltage and current? So V in minus VZ divided by what is your current? Current is equal to your IZ. So whenever your IZ is maximum, current is maximum, you will be getting your minimum value of the resistance, right? So we can tell that the power dissipated or the maximum power is equal to, what will be your maximum power, which is equal to IZ into VZ, right? IZ maximum into VZ. So can we substitute this formula here? So RS minimum is equal to V in minus VZ divided by what is your IZ max is equal to PZ max divided by VZ. So this VZ goes to the numerator, V in minus VZ into VZ divided by PZ maximum, which is equal to V in into VZ minus VZ square divided by PZ maximum. So I can tell that RS minimum is equal to V in into VZ minus VZ square divided by PZ maximum. Let me take this as equation 2. Now we can see a problem related to this. Okay. So example 6.4. A 5 volt Zener diode has a maximum rated power dissipation of 500 milliwatt. Okay. So what is your VZ given? VZ is equal to 5 volt. Okay. And maximum power dissipation is equal to PZ max is equal to 500 milliwatt. Okay. Now, if the diode is to be used in a simple regulator circuit to supply a regulated 5 volt to a load having a resistance of 400 ohm. Okay. So, load resistor RL is also given. How much is the value? 400 ohm. Determine a suitable value of series resistor for operation in conjunction with a supply voltage. So V in is also given. So what you have to find out? You have to find out the limits of RS, that is RS max and RX minimum. And you have to find out the suitable value. So only if we find out RS max and RS minimum, we are going to we can approximate what may be the value. Okay. So what is the previous equation what we have got? Rs max is equal to, so let me write the equation of Rs max and Rs minimum. Rs max is equal to RL into V in divided by VZ minus 1, and Rs minimum is equal to V in into VZ minus VZ square divided by PZ max. So these are the two equations. Okay, so let me first find out what is Rs max. So what will be your Rs max? RL is equal to 400 ohm. Okay, V in is equal to 9 divided by what is your VZ 5 minus 1. Okay, so 400, 9 minus 5 divided by 5. So what you will be getting, 400 into 4 by 5, right? 4 by 5. So 1 5 is 5, 8 5s are 40, 0, 8 4s are 32. So you will be getting 320 ohm. So Rs max is equal to 320 ohm. Now can we find out what is Rs minimum? Rs minimum is equal to, what is your equation? V in is 9 into VZ. VZ is equal to 5 minus VZ square. 5 square, it is 25 divided by PZ max is equal to 500 milliwatt. Okay. So 9 5 is 45 minus 25 divided by 500. What is milli? 10 raised to minus 3. Right. So which is equal to 25, 35, 45. So 20 divided by 500 into 10 raised to minus 3. Cancel to 25. So you will be getting 1 by, if I take this 10 raised to minus 3 in the top, you will be getting it as 1000, right? Into 25. So I can cancel 5, 5 is 25, 2 5 is 10, 0, 0, 1 5 is 5, 4 5 is 20, 0. So the value is equal to 40 ohm. Rs minimum is equal to 40 ohm. I have got the answer. Okay. Now what is the question? Determine a suitable value of the resistor for operation. So the value for resistor Rs should lie between 40 ohm, between 40 ohm and 320 ohm. So we can approximate it to 100 to or 150 value. Okay. It's a suitable value.